the Business of Being a Virtual Assistant. I'm your host, Tiffany Parson, and welcome. This is episode number 146. Now, today I am answering a viewer question, and I thought it would be perfect for everyone to hear the response as well as for her to get more information. Now, I've already emailed and responded, but I knew she was not the only one with this question. So let's dive into the question. Now, it came in from Cece, and I just want to give you a shout out and thank you so much for your email. She is a new listener and just found me literally the other day. She started with episode number 96, and she's just going through them all back to back to back. I can already tell she is going to be a rock star in her virtual assistant business. Now, here is Cece's question, and she wrote a lot, so I'm going to dig around and get right to her question. Okay, she says, I just have a question because I feel like I'm all over the place. I read that I should also build a website. I read your article on that. I was going to use Namecheap, HostGator, and WordPress. My question is this something I need to do immediately? Or would you recommend starting with the Upwork challenge? I don't want to fall victim to being overloaded with information and not taking the steps I need in the order in which I need to take them. Hope that makes sense. Let's see some other questions. What should be my first step? And how do I build a portfolio, proposal? I know you're not supposed to send a traditional resume, but I have no clue what she even looked like. She was gonna do business cards and flyers and on. And she says, am I getting ahead of myself? Feels like I'm running my mouth too much. So then she closes out her email. I love all your questions, Cece. Q&A is like my absolute favorite thing ever. I love Q&A, whether it's directed towards me or I'm listening in to someone else's Q&A. Love, love, love it. So, all of you guys, thank you so much for listening. If you have questions similar to Cece's, just email, let me know. You can even send me a message on Facebook. Either way, I will get it, and I will bring your question here to the podcast. And if it's something I can't answer, I'll at least point you in the right direction. Now, let's go backwards and look at her question. The first thing is, do you need a website to get started as a virtual assistant? The answer is no. You do not need a website to start. If your plan is to get clients on Upwork, guess what? You don't need a website for that because your Upwork profile is going to serve as your portfolio, as the place to find out information about you. That is your home, so to speak, within Upwork. It is rare that potential clients on Upwork will even ask you for your website. The only way it will come into the picture is if it is relative, if you're using it as an example of what you have done and you give them the link. They may not even realize it's your website. In fact, you don't even have to say it's my website. It's just a website where I've written blog posts or scheduled posts or whatever it is, and however it is, you're using it as an example. Now, let's say you decide you want to start getting clients using LinkedIn. Well, LinkedIn would serve as your profile. You can also use it as your portfolio, but you will need a website because the expectation is that if you're a business, you're a service provider, you have a website. So when you're within the cocoon of Upwork, no website needed. But once you go outside of that, LinkedIn, Pinterest, Instagram, Facebook, word of mouth, face to face, people will expect you to have a website, even if it's just a one-page website. It doesn't have to be a WordPress website. It doesn't have to be hosted, you know, have your own hosting. You may just want to do what I call a starter website, where you go on Strikingly, create you a one-page website, and let that get you going. In the show notes, I'm going to post a link of the evolution of my website, Virtual Hire Hand, and show you what it looked like way back when I first built it. And this was long before I ever started using WordPress. I think it was in HTML and everything like that. But I find the article I wrote to show the evolution of a website. To know that your website will always be changing. What you don't want to always change is your domain name. So for example, my domain name is Virtual Hired Hand. It's been that since I created the website back in, I don't even know what year it was, but since I decided on a business name, that has been the domain name since forever, at least 10 years. So that's something you don't want to change, because once you put it out there, people will know that's your website address. So, but there are other options. A one page will do, or none at all if you're going to stay within Upwork. So you got some options. It's based on how you choose to start. The other thing is about a portfolio. And I had this question come up in Facebook as well. Someone was wanting to know, where should they get started? And you know, my number one place to point you is Upwork, because the clients are there, the services are there. If nothing else, you can at least see, what are people looking for? Upwork has all of that information for you. When it comes to a portfolio, if you have zero clients right now, you may be wondering, well, how can I create a portfolio? I don't have any clients. If you've ever played the game where you, when you were little, of having imaginary friends, now is time to reactivate that skill that you used when you were a kid. If you used to read to your dolls, or you played office, or you played store, and you had imaginary customers, we're gonna use that same skill to create your portfolio. Imagine you have customers based on the service you want to provide. Now, you can use yourself as an example for your portfolio. Let's say you want to help people schedule their blog posts or their e-newsletters. Guess what? You need a website with a blog, and you need an account with MailChimp or AWeber or somebody who does email newsletters, so you can start doing those, and now you know what it's like. Now you can use those things as an example, even if it's not to show, but just to demonstrate it in words. Everything we do is not gonna be in a portfolio. If you're sending out your clients' newsletters, you can't use their newsletters as in your portfolio. If you're creating graphics for clients and they have not approved you to use their graphics for your portfolio, guess what? You can't use that. So we gotta be very careful with all we put in our portfolio, but for your imaginary clients, they say, go ahead, you can do whatever you want. So you can create a graphic, you can create social media posts, you can write articles, use your imagination and provide the portfolio based on that. Now, what you can also do, let's say that you plan to edit articles, and this person on Upwork, they have a wellness and fitness business, and they want articles edited for wellness and fitness. Well, guess what you can do? Go ahead, write an article on wellness and fitness, show the before, show the after that you edited it. Why? Why should you do that? Because one, it fits their industry. You're already showing that you have an interest in wellness and fitness. And then by showing the before and after, they can see your editing skills. So start thinking about, how can I show people and use my imaginary clients or myself as the example. And remember, everything is not going to be visual. You won't be able to put everything in your portfolio just yet, and that is okay. But start. Don't tell me that you don't have a portfolio and you can't create one. That's excuses. Imaginary clients work just fine. Examples, right? Because our portfolio is to show an example of what we have done. And if you have done, like in the editing example, you wrote the article, you edited it, hello, now we have a wonderful sample. For those who do ghostwriting, they can't show all the articles and writing that they have done for other people. They have to have something else that's never been used. For those who do sales pages, they can't just use their client's sales pages. They've got to come up with something else to show as an example, some type of template. If you're a bookkeeper and you want to show that you know how to do the Excel spreadsheets and the calculations, create the imaginary numbers, plug them in, show it. If you're doing graphics or Google Analytics and different things like that with the data, show it using fake data. When you create websites, they have, I can't remember, it's like Lyft Forum or something, where you can even go get dummy content to add to a website to use as an example. So have fun creating your portfolio. And everything you need, you won't have at the beginning because you won't know. You won't know all the services that you want to provide. I always recommend to start with what you already have. If you're offering email support, you can't have what kind of portfolio can you have for email support? Maybe you can have example questions that people ask and you provide your response. Think about general FAQs that people would have on a website based on the industries that your clients are in. You can even modify it each time you submit a proposal specific to that particular client. So I want you to be creative and use your imagination in building your portfolio, and know that you won't have every single example at the beginning because you don't know what you don't know. Let it flow, have fun with it, and know that the portfolio information you use on Upwork can also be transferred to all the other places as well. You just might want to make it a little prettier if you're going to put it on Instagram, or a little prettier if you're putting it on Facebook, or a bit more professional if you're putting it on LinkedIn. Lots of different options. So you're not just creating for the Upwork people, you're creating it for everybody. So that may have caused you to have a whole bunch of questions. Hopefully not, because that means I was not clear at all if you have a whole lot of questions. What I hope is that it's gotten your wheels turning and you're ready for me to be quiet so you can go ahead and get started on your portfolio and enjoy the creative process and go get you some new clients. Thank you guys so much for listening and for watching. If you've enjoyed this episode, then share it with your friends. Comment below and let me know, or head on over to iTunes and post your review for the podcast. I appreciate every single one of you. You have no idea that when you email me, it blesses me. Just when you say hello or thanks, I got it, whatever, just hearing from you lets me know you're on the other side. And this is exactly why I come on every week and give you some more information on building your virtual assistant business. If you'd like to even go even deeper with me, every single month I do that in my virtual assistant business owner circle. I would love to have you. You just go to tiffanyparson.com/VABOC. And if you're ready to hop on the free email list, go ahead and do that by texting 345-345, and you want to text the phrase VA start, all together, one word, VA for virtual assistant start. I look forward to the next time. You have a wonderful and fabulous day.